What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory, where safety is number one priority. And today I'm going to put to the test more kitchen gadgets. Let's see what I got this time. Can you believe it? They have made asparagus prep peeler. I didn't even know that you're supposed to peel asparagus. So it looks like they were peeling it this way. Oh wow, that's pretty skinny. I wouldn't even know that it has been peeled or not, because it doesn't take off a lot of peel. Whoa, so I guess that way you don't have that hard, thick piece. This is so sharp, I can't believe it, it works so well. There you go. Next time you cook asparagus, make sure you peel them. It works so well, it is super satisfying. Let me do a little bit closer. So that's what it looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 6 times and then it's completely peeled. What do you guys think? Should you peel asparagus or should you leave it alone the way it is? Let me know in comments below. Very unique gadget, definitely high quality and works. For the next gadget, you know, this milk is really bulky, really hard to hold. Even with my big hands, it's uncomfortable. So instead, just grab one of these gadgets. It's any box carton holder. You put it in, now you have a holder. And it looks beautiful too. Look how much easier it is to pour it in. Especially if you have weaker hands, I don't know, maybe injured or smaller hands. It is way easier to just grab it, hold it, put it down, close it. Once you're done, take it out, put the different one. And it will work with orange juice or any kind of box like that. I really like that gadget a lot. For the next gadget, I got here olive stoner. Let's see how it works. So you grab your olives and you need to pit it. Oh no, for the green ones, it's almost too small. Yeah, definitely too small, crushing the green olives. So it's more so for these black ones. Works really well, check this out. Skinny olives, removes it, put it down. I like it. Boom. A little bit explodes it, but at the same time works really well. So no complaints about this olive speeder for the black olives, but for the green olives, as you can see, a bit too small for sure. The pit won't even go through the hole, now it's stuck. Let me show it to you a little bit better angle. Boom. Another one. And couple more so you guys see what's going on. You see how it removes the olive? Very nice. One more. This is pretty satisfying actually. Perfect. But let's see if I have even better one. So this is a design like that. As you can see, it is much thicker, so it will fit the big ones. But no help with that, because now my pits don't go through this hole either. So looks like this gadget is also pretty much only for the smaller black olives. And now it's getting stuck. Wow, this is completely fail. I thought this one would work with green ones, but so far it does not work with any of them that well. You see it gets stuck. First one was a bit better than this one. Let's do one more so you guys can see the bigger one. Yeah, no way, it's stuck. And it gets stuck on the way out too. Fail. Well, guess what? Now that we peel a bunch of olives, I have olive stuffer. Looks like they advertise black olives anyways. Okay, so what we'll do is stick it into a cheese, you see it? And how do we stuff it? This hole isn't big enough. There you go. You put it in and then release it. And now it's stuffed. Okay, that's actually cool. Put it into the cheese again. Boom. And then put it into the olive and then press it down and it's going to stuff it with cheese. I don't know if you can see it, but there you go. That actually works really good. Another one, stick it into the cheese. Boom. Okay, where's the hole? I think in the back end it is better. And that way you can stuff your olives with any cheese or whatever you like, not just buy it. Very, very unique way to stuff your olives. Who would have thought you can now stuff your olives yourselves? Pretty fun, isn't it? Okay, stick it into the olive, stuff it. Super cool. Okay, one more. Get some cheese. Push it in, stuff it. That one kind of broke apart. I mean, I can't complain, look at that. They all works really good. Stuffed it with my own favorite cheese if I want to. Super unique. If you have really expensive, super sharp knives, it's really easy to cut your finger off almost. So, what you can get is gadgets like that. Instead of using your actual fingers to cut it up, you probably seen it on the cooking channels, they use a finger like that to cut stuff up. But what if you cut your finger? So get yourself this nail guards or finger guards. Now that you can chop up stuff without worrying about cutting yourself. And look at that, this is so nice. This is super expensive knife. Somebody sent it to me in fan mail. Thank you so much, by the way. But now I don't have to worry about cutting myself. Look how thin I can do this with my knife. And this is the easiest way to cut stuff using the nail. And you see how it comes up a bit. You can adjust this by just folding this right here. And that way it will sit even better. So you can guide it instead of your fingers, guide this metal nail. You can put it on all of your fingers, only on two fingers, whatever. Safety is number one priority, remember? There you go, finger guards. Look how well it's cutting. Very, very sharp knife. I love this knife. That's a really good gadget right here. But even better, make sure your fingers are safe. I like it. For the next gadget, this one is pretty new and sold everywhere. This is silicone pressure cooker, egg rack and sling. So pretty much you can use it for anything, but perfect also for the regular pots to boil eggs in. You know, if you drop eggs into the pot, sometimes they will break. So this way you can just put them like that, or this way. I have here bigger eggs. Wow, look at that. By the way, all these eggs laid my chickens. And one in the middle. Whoa, this is pretty satisfying. And then you can lift it up, carry it and put it into the pot. This one is probably better to put them this way. There you go. Lift them up, put them in the pot, no problem. Pretty... Okay, maybe they don't hold up that well. You know what, I wish the holes were a bit bigger. But yeah, maybe hold it like that so the eggs don't drop, and then you would put it in the boiling water. Let's try it out. Okay, let's drop these eggs, see what happens. The only problem is I would have to use the biggest pot because all my other pots wouldn't even fit. Ah, you see, they kind of float away anyways. So I don't know. For the egg holder, not so much. Maybe it will be much more useful for other stuff, but yeah. Let me know in comments below, what do you think? But you know what? Probably I'm using it on anyways. So let's say the eggs boiled. Let's try to lift them up. Boom, and you can lift them all at once. I know, interesting gadget. Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below which gadget was your favorite. Don't forget to thumbs up this video, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.